Shouted Hosanna, Hosanna. When Jesus entered Jerusalem, Hosanna. The people shouted Hosanna, oh, hallelujah, Hosanna, 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 Hosanna. When Jesus entered Jerusalem, Hosanna. The people shouted, Hosanna, Hosanna. When Jesus entered Jerusalem, Hosanna. The people shouted, Hosanna, oh, hallelujah, Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna. Yes, so when Jesus entered Jerusalem, the people shouted, Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna. And they got palms. Then some even got blankets. And they put those things down for Jesus to walk on it. Today, my question for you is, what kind of blanket are you holding for Jesus to walk on it? What kind of palms are you holding, or palm leaves are you holding for Jesus to walk on it? Like I said, what kind of palm are you holding? Are you holding a fake palm? Because the same people who held those palm leaves, who decorated those palm leaves, are the same people who said, kill him, kill him, kill him, kill him, nail him to the cross. That even when they saw Peter, they said, this one too walks with him, because maybe at his entry, they could see Peter with him, you know. So this one too walks with him, right? They did not want to leave any stone unturned. They are the same people who held those palm leaves and they were shouting, Hosanna, Hosanna, the Hosanna. Right? They were shouting and praising God and happy that Jesus Christ, Son of God, has come into their lives, or has come into their city. So with doing a reflection to ourselves, using that Bible portion as a reflection to yourself, it's the same as you letting Jesus in into your life. That moment you say, Lord Jesus, come into my life and make me a whole new person. I acknowledge that I am a sinner. I acknowledge that I have sinned against you, against myself, against the people around me. Please forgive me. Come into my life and make me a new person. Jesus does what? He walks into your life. You are putting those palms. But as trials and temptation keeps coming, what happens? You forget. You forget so soon that you had asked him to come into your life. You forget so soon that that same Jesus that you had taken out all the lies telling and said you are going to be speaking the truth is in your life. But what is happening? You are now still, you have gone back to your old ways. You forget so soon. So it's the same as him entering Jerusalem is a significant of him entering our lives. That is how I see it. That is how I see this Palm Sunday. So how are you celebrating Palm Sunday? Are you letting Jesus come into your life and making you a new person and actually changing from that thing you're doing that is evil? Are you letting Jesus come into your life and actually setting things straight and setting things right? Or are you just letting him come into your life like they say, follow the crowd, because you saw others holding palm leaves, blankets and everything, you wanted to do your own so that they will see that, yes, this girl or this man too can do it? Is that what you're up to? As for me, I know Jesus is in my heart. I had accepted Jesus and I got baptized, water baptism by immersion. Yes, I was emerged. I took inquiry classes, I think, for about 3 months, if I can remember correctly. That's so many years ago, at the age of 16. That's when I got baptized. That's when I said, Jesus, you know what? Come into my life. I am turning away from all these things. But before that time, I had given my life to Christ. I was serving him. I think I gave my life to Christ at the age of 13. Yes. I was serving him. And then when I got to 16, I said, God, indeed, I have to get baptized. Because I have found the truth in you and it has set me free. Only that truth in you, oh God, has brought me to where I am today. And because I led Jesus in my life, if I start telling you the testimony of the things that he has done for me, Pastor Mark for talk. That's why I say, if I could say thank you to you, oh Lord, if I had 10,000 tongues, it still wouldn't be enough. What shall I render to the Lord for all that he has done for me? What can I give God? Even my tongue, the whole world join me to sing, it's still not enough. But there's so much love, there's so much blessing, there's so much joy, there's so much peace, there's so much calmness that even when sometimes I feel like, oh God, you have left me. But as soon as I turn to my right, I see his hand evident. I turn to my left, I see him evident everywhere I turn. I look even up in the skies. I see the clouds. And I say, oh God, you are a beautiful God. You are a good, good Father. That even as you have come into my life, I am not going to turn to be like the Jerusalemites or the people in Jerusalem. No. I am not going to be like them. I am going to let you in my life. For real. And since then, that is how it has been. Have I been perfect throughout I got baptized? No, that's not what I'm saying. But I know in me that Jesus is in me. That is why you will not see me hurting someone deliberately. No, that is not me. I cannot hurt someone deliberately. Knowingly, no. I cannot hurt someone knowingly because when Jesus came into my life, he made my conscience come alive. For those people who have dead conscience, for those people who have unforgiving spirit, your heart is so heavy that people do things to you, you hold them. You are staying with those things. You are staying with those things. No, and you don't want to let go. You don't want to let go. Sometimes you even let go, people still carry you and bring you back into things that you have let go. Just why? Because they have seen that you let go. What happens? They begin to be angry. Why has she let go so soon? Right? If I can remember last Sunday, we had an incident in this house where they had to take us to something that happened some years ago, and it wasn't me who even brought that thing up. Right? But then again, at the end of the day, I say, oh God, the devil is a liar. Things that you have buried and let go, let them be there. Move on. Move on. You know, and you know, it's Palm Sunday, although it is the way it is with all the corona virus thing going on. Excuse me, it's not the end of the world yet. It is just the beginning of the end of the world. If you are reading your Bible correctly, you will see that these are just some of the signs of the things that are yet to come. It means that those who may come 5, 4, 7, 100, 300, 400,000 years from us, they will be the ones to really experience that end of the world things. Right now, we are just experiencing the first stage of level pain that the woman is having, as the Bible says it. It's just the level pain that we are experiencing right now. The real pain is yet to come. Every woman that has given birth will know what I'm talking about. When you have dilated 1 or 2 centimeters, it's just a kick here and there. Maybe you can have the cramps today and it takes for another Sunday before you have another cramp. We are still at that level. But even though we are still at that level, we have to make our peace with God. We have to put those palm fronds or palm tree or palm leaves or blankets or whatever we are putting down for Jesus. We have to actually put them down. These people, they put those palm, those decorative things there, but later on what happened? The content of their heart was evil. It's like you walking into somebody's house, the person is giving you your favorite food when there is poison in it. That's how I can call it. Why have we become so evil? Why have we become so evil? We are not different from the people of the time of Jerusalem. We are not different from them. No. That was the triumphant entry. like I still say that I compare that entry to be Jesus entering in my life. That's how he walked into your house triumphantly. But at the end of the day, what happened? Crucify him, crucify him. You deny him. We even have some people that will deny him. When time will come when you have received Christ and people are asking you what's going on with you, instead of saying that, you know what, I found Jesus and he set my soul free, you will be like, I know, Seth. How do you know to where it happened? That's you, Peter. And then others will be like Judas. That will say, they will say, I'm giving up beer because I've seen that beer is my weakness. I'm not going to be drinking. I'm not going to be hanging out. But as soon as they hear someone say, come, let's go hang out, instead of telling them that, you know what, I have made my peace with Jesus. I have spoken to Jesus and I'm giving up drinking. You know, the first thing you think in your mind, let it be Jesus. Say, Jesus, okay, I better go drink. That's the prayer right there. Make your peace with Jesus. The days are evil. We are not yet at the end of the world. It's just the beginning. It's just the beginning of the end of the world. The worst is yet to come. If Corona can shut the world down and it feels like we are all in space, then imagine the things that are yet to come. And you are still there, wondering, going about saying and talking things that do not lift your spirit up. Things that if I die today, I know that the Lord is waiting for me. Yes, I am sure and know and I believe and I trust that he has my spirit, he has my soul, he has my body, my everything belongs to him. I am sure of where I am going. I am sure 100% that the Lord will say, you know what, my daughter, you were not perfect. You were not perfect. And because judgment is mine, I am going to pass judgment to you according to the things that you did while you were yet on earth. And if my goods, the good things I did, outweigh the bad things, trust me, there is no how my God will not let me into this kingdom. Sometimes I get into quarrel here with my husband and I say, you know what? I'm not going to talk to you or argue or shout or say cursing word or all those things because I'm not going to let you stop me from seeing God's face. Yes, that's how I get over issues sometimes. I say, you, this person, this individual, don't think that what you are doing to me will make me not see God's face. You lie. I forgive you and I move on. Nobody, nothing on earth is going to stop this girl from seeing the face of God. That's my goal. That's my only desire. I don't desire riches. Mm-mm. I don't desire fame. Mm-mm. That's not what I desire. I want to see the face of my Creator, the one who made me to look like him. He said he made me in his image, right? So I definitely look like him. I want to see him. And if he can make me like this on earth, then in heaven, just imagine how I look. Just imagine how this girl will look in heaven. How you will look in heaven. How, oh God. So as you're letting those palm fronds of palm leaves and trees and branches and brooms and mats and blankets down for Jesus to walk on, also let him in your heart. Let Jesus in your heart. Let him come to your heart and make you a new person. Let him change you. Let him bring light into your body. Serve him wholeheartedly. Seek God and everything will be added. Stop following prophecies. Stop following riches. Stop following help or all those things that these people come online. I need 4 people to come here. Let me prophesy. Stop following those things and seek God. Get the Bible. Read that Bible. You will find God explaining to you who he is in the Bible. Read that Bible, seek God, and every other thing he will add them to you. You don't even need to ask those things. When you seek him, he will be giving you those things. You will just be seeing those things happening because that is who he said he is. He is a truthful God, a man of his word. The I am that I am, the mighty man in battle. When he says yes, nobody can say no. When he opens that door, nobody dares to shut it. Yes, seek God. Bye, choppers. Do have a nice Palm Sunday and let Jesus into your life just like I did some years ago.